In an Australian cricket team already full of stars, Usman Khawaja stands out. He's a fine batsman and an agile fielder, but there's something else. He's a Muslim. In fact, the first Muslim to ever wear the baggy green cap. Usman says it hasn't always been easy being different to his teammates. And in the past, he's hated the attention placed on his faith. But now, he's proud to celebrate it. Which brings us to something else he has to celebrate. Something even better than scoring a century. His wedding.
Allahu Akbar.
In a suburban mosque in Brisbane,
Sami Allahu
Usman Khawaja is just another devout Muslim, saying his midday prayers, focused in quiet worship.
Religion's the most important thing in my life. Everything I do, it's always in the back of my mind. I'm always thinking, you know, is this the right thing to do? Is this how I should be doing things?
But get the 31-year-old on a cricket pitch and there's no sign of modesty.
There it goes, well played.
To his teammates, Usman is the elegant batsman and the resident prankster.
Oh, yes! The moment Usman Khawaja will never forget.
Who is breaking down barriers as the first Muslim to ever play cricket for Australia.
Do you ever pray for a ton?
I'd be lying if I did it.
Just asking for, you know, a little hand to you, please, God.
Probably ask for lots of, you know, lots of tons, lots of runs and a good-looking wife.
He listened.
En route to the AB, was he excited?
Yes.
That wife-to-be is 22-year-old Rachel McClellan.
Stop filming me.
A good Catholic girl who this devoted Muslim just happened to fall in love with.
Had you ever known any Muslims before you met Usman?
No, I didn't know any. So I went to an all-girls Catholic private school. So
And she lives in Brisbane.
And I live in Brisbane. So Ussie was the first Muslim I've ever met. So I was very ignorant before I met Ussie. I will admit to that. All I read was, well, terrorists and all, you know, all the awful things you read.
Yeah, she thought when I was first met her that I was gonna like tie my wife up in chains and keep her in a dungeon or something.
No, I didn't.
Only when she misbehaves.
Only if she deserves it.
Usman Khawaja was born in Islamabad, Pakistan. He arrived in Sydney in 1991 as a five-year-old with his parents Tariq and Fozia and his two older brothers.
Uzi's uncle is using my Thai pad as his main pad.
His father chose Australia because cricket was played here.
No, I didn't speak the language. English was my second language. So when I went to kindergarten, the teacher asked me, oh, you know, hello, how are you? I just looked at my mum and in Urdu, I said, what's she saying? Just a young
girl with a quick view. Even back then, Usman was cricket mad. I was dreaming of bigger things and good.
The passion at the young age, the game would start at 9 o'clock. And I used to wake up around 7 o'clock. And I would see him ready with his kit, sitting on a couch.
Ready
so that
to
was
go.
The limit of his passion.
Everybody's sleeping but he.
Yeah.
That bat looks way too big for me.
Yeah, it does.
Looks like you're barely swinging.
Every weekend was spent playing cricket, all recorded on Dad Tariq's trusty camcorder.
He filmed everything.
Yeah.
It wasn't just cricket. He filmed everything.
I think I had a feeling one day he was going to play.
As Usman started to make a name for himself.
Four.
Oh, four.
The backlash was, at times, vile.
Were you exposed to racism?
Yeah, definitely.
What kind of things would they say?
Some of the stuff could be pretty vulgar. Some of the stuff could be pretty hurtful. One of the parents, in earshot of me, just nailed me, called me a black, backy C-T.
It was those kind of comments, the drinking culture of the sport, and the fact his skin colour didn't match anyone on the national team that left the impressionable teenager feeling alienated.
There was no one that looked like me in the Australian cricket team.
Why did that matter?
It just reiterated to me that maybe I was a little bit different, and it just felt like I will support Australia and the Australian cricket, but you know, would the Australian cricket then support me?
Growing up, were you ever told that you wouldn't make it?
Yeah, a lot of times. I go to Pakistani families, dinners and stuff, and they'd be like, you'll never make Australia. I was like, why not? It's like, you're not the right skin colour. What it did do was made me really hungry to be better. You know, you're going to have to just score runs and more runs, and not let anyone have any excuse to not pick you.
That determination saw Usman rise to the top of his sport. In 2011, he was chosen to play for his country. But his form was patchy and he was often in and out of the team.
That's gone high, it's a chance of a catch and taken.
So a year later, he made the move from Sydney to play for the state team in Brisbane. A decision that led him to marketing student Rachel.
How important was it to your parents that you marry a nice Muslim girl?
Extremely. The nice Muslim Pakistani girl from a nice family. It just kept coming back in. And I think at the end, it was like, just marry a nice Muslim girl.
If you have a Muslim mother, that ensures that your kids are going to be Muslim as well. From his perspective, it's more important that he marries someone who he really loves.
Knowing how important Islam was to Usman and his family, and realising how strong her feelings were for the cricketer, Rachel started to think about converting.
I bear witness.
And in a simple ceremony last year, did so.
Did you feel pressure to convert to Islam for Usman?
Not at all. Not any pressure from him, not any pressure from his family. I just knew it was so important to him.
So this was totally your decision?
Yes.
Is what you said? Yeah.
I never was going to put a gun to Rachel's head and say, you have to convert. I told her that I'd prefer her to convert, but she has to do it on her own, because unless it comes from you, it comes from the heart, then there's no point doing it.
Oh, it's very sticky.
This is paratha.
Okay.
So you do it like that?
Yeah.
Usman's parents are ecstatic that Rachel is embracing not only Islam, but also their Pakistani heritage.
More longer.
Yeah. What does that do? Does it make it bigger?
Yeah.
And while Rachel's cooking isn't quite as accomplished as Fozia's, she's having fun learning.
We've got two families. You've got my family and we've got Rachel's family, who is Christian. So it's like, you know, there's times where there's Christmas celebrated and I'm not, you know, Nazi going, no, they can't celebrate Christmas. And I'm like, yeah.
Just no Christmas ham.
Yes.
Yeah, just no Christmas
ham. That was
ham.
A big one. That was a very sad one to let go of. Oh, it was sad, but worth it. It's a small sacrifice.
So how's your golf game coming? Pretty good when you're not sledging me.
In the Khawaja household, the women rule the kitchen. But today, the blokes are in charge of the barbecue.
I think you're a slightly better cricketer.
I hope so. Yeah.
Rachel's parents, John and Michelle, couldn't be happier that their youngest daughter is about to become Mrs. Khawaja.
He said, I love your daughter and I want to ask your permission to marry her. So, and it was lovely that he asked the both of us, in his words, because I didn't want to miss it. He knew I wouldn't want to miss out.
How did people respond when you told them that Rachel was converting to Islam?
Most people were a little surprised at first, and they would just sort of say, what are they doing about the religion side of things? And I'd say, well, she's converted and she's now a Muslim. And they were like, well, that's why Muslims are taking over the world, because they make their girlfriends convert before they'll marry them. But the people closest to us and to Rachel and Ussie have always been very accepting of it.
For me, it wasn't, you know, it wasn't an issue at all.
And John, you get an Australian cricketer as a son-in-law.
Well, I'm a sport tragic, a test cricketer as a future son-in-law. I couldn't be happier.
Stop licking me.
A lot of times, a lot of the hate I get is from other Muslims, you know, on social media, whatnot.
Really? Like in what sense?
Like, we'll put up a photo of us two, it'll be like, oh, she's not Muslim, that's haram, you can't marry her.
Which is totally incorrect, because she is Muslim.
People don't know that. Love is forever.
In April, Usman will tie the knot with Rachel in what they're calling their big white wedding. But in the eyes of Allah, they're already married, with their imam performing a nikah, a traditional Muslim commitment ceremony last year, which allows the couple to live together.
Still have a very long way to go and lots of learning, so, yeah, I look forward to, inshallah, hopefully one day being as knowledgeable as Ussie.
Usman is now in South Africa playing a series of tests in the baggy green. His position in the Australian side cemented after a stunning performance at the SCG in January. You looked so nervous when he was in the 90s.
Yeah, I was nervous that time.
There it goes, well played, Khawaja. Usman Khawaja, his first 100 at the Sydney Cricket Ground.
What was your reaction?
Oh, so much. I said, thank God. Everything is okay.
I watched cricket there countless numbers of times when I was a kid. And to score a century there meant so much. It was one of those things that I always wanted to do.
For Usman's father, Tariq, this was the dream he'd always imagined for his son.
To be very frank, I don't know why. It was the first time I had
first Muslim test cricketer in Australia.
I don't like that headline, to be honest.
Why not?
I've never liked that headline. I just wanted to play cricket.
For years, Usman Khawaja hated the focus on his faith. He wanted his cricket and that alone to do the talking.
Yeah, I love you.
But now, as he and Rachel begin the next chapter of their life together, he's proud to be the poster boy for the religion he lives by.
Good boy.
If you had to choose cricket or faith?
Faith. Yeah, any day of the week. I love my cricket. Rachel knows cricket means the world to me. And sometimes I have to remind myself that only one will, inshallah, be with us after we pass away and you know, hopefully do well enough to go to heaven.